Hello. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. We can kill the house lights. Thank you so much. We hope you enjoyed being carried away to a warmer time just a second ago. That was Wave by Carlos Chopin. He is kind of the bossa nova guy. He's a Brazilian composer. This next chart we're going to play, and if you've been to our concerts before, we always start, Jazz Orchestra always starts the year learning a Count Basie chart, and that's because most jazz musicians agree that if you can't play Basie, then you can't swing. And so this chart is one of his most famous. It's from the title, it's the title from the album Basie Straight Ahead. Thank you very much. That was the PHS Jazz Orchestra. We're going to have a quick transition to get the band on stage. If you give us just a minute, we'll get everybody else going. patient when we made that change. This concert that we're going to be playing tonight for the concert band is kind of a unique thing, and I wanted to give you a heads up about before we play our first piece. And it was this. I was very lucky this last summer to do some traveling, and as you do when you travel, I ate a lot of food, which was awesome. And I realized that music and food have a very common thread, which is you put all this work into it, and then you do it, and it's gone. Right? And so I was particularly inspired by a restaurant I was eating in Italy where they served ridiculous portions, which was delicious, but it started out with something common, like pasta. And then the second dish was something much more complex. And then they always finished with coffee or a sweet or something like that. And that's more or less the oral journey that we're going to take you on tonight. So we're starting out with something familiar and light. You're going to recognize it right away. We hope you enjoy our spin on it. Sleigh Ride by Leroy Anderson. This is is a grade six. The subcategory is collegiate band for this level of music. And this piece of music is an interesting one because not only is it very famous, but it's an interesting thing because there's something we don't have very often, and that is a speaker. And that is actually Mr. Brandon Pink. If I haven't come out so we could recognize him, Mr. Brandon Pink is our speaker tonight. Scoring his speech. So this piece, Lincoln Portrait, as you might imagine, is a portrait of Abraham Lincoln, and it's quotes that he actually said scattered around. And what's interesting about this piece is it was written during World War II, and they wanted something that was significant, that was going to exemplify an American patriot. So they went to Aaron Copland and said, "Aaron, would you write this piece?" And he said, "Of course, we need a portrait of an American patriot. I know it's just the guy, Walt Whitman." And they were like, "No, let's do Lincoln." "Okay, let's do Lincoln." And they came up with Lincoln. And this piece does have need a little bit of explanation as well, though. These speeches were what he said. It was both when he was president and leading up to when he was president. And there's the original text. We didn't edit it at all. So we do want to acknowledge that one of the speeches that he uses the term slave and slave master, and we acknowledge that in 2023 we would use enslaved person and enslaver. But we didn't want to edit the speech. It's exactly the way he said it. The other thing is you're going to notice what sounds a lot like Camptown Races. It's not Camptown Races. It's actually a genius thing that he did at the time. They co-opted that melody and used it as a campaign slogan for Abraham Lincoln. So every time you whistled that tune, it'd be a way to spread Abraham Lincoln's campaign. So all that to say, we hope you enjoy this monster of a piece. We've really enjoyed putting it together.
Thank you. to the latest generation. even we here, hold the power and bear the responsibility. He was born in Kentucky, raised in Indiana, and lived in Illinois. And this is what he said. This is what Abe Lincoln said. The dogmas of the quiet past are inadequate to the stormy present. The occasion is piled high with difficulty, and we must rise with the occasion. As our case is new, so we must think anew and act anew. It is the eternal struggle between two principles, right and wrong, throughout the world. It is the same spirit that says, you toil and work and earn bread, and I'll eat it, no matter in what shape it comes. Whether from the mouth of a king who seeks to bestride the people of his own nation and to live by the fruit of their labor, or from one race of men as an apology for enslaving another race, it is the same tyrannical principle. Lincoln was a quiet man. Abe Lincoln was a quiet and melancholy man. But when he spoke of democracy, this is what he said. He said, as I would not be a slave, so I would not be a master. This expresses my idea of democracy. Whatever differs from this, Abraham Lincoln, 16th President of these United States, is everlasting in the memory of his countrymen. For on the battleground at Gettysburg, this is what he said. He said that from these honored dead, we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion. That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain, and that this nation, under God, shall have a new birth of freedom, and that government of the people, by the people, and for the people shall not perish from the earth.
Concert. We hope that you had some good year food tonight, and we'll see you next time. Have a great evening.